There's something else that I read in there the other day that says, now unto him that's able to do exceedingly abundantly, I ain't got no Bible readers on this side, above anything that we could ask, think, or imagine. And I begin to think about the fact that I don't know about that because I've got a mighty big imagination. And so if I've got a mighty big imagination, then that must mean we must be serving a what? A mighty big God. If you believe it, I dare you to clap your hands in here. Come on, let's have church. He said I could have the desires of my heart if I delight myself in the Lord. As long as I ask it in his name, there is nothing that I can't ask him for. But I'm just kind of wondering if my definition of anything is the same as his. If it is, then that should tell me how big God really is. Cause he said that he can do more than I can ask or think. And for him, nothing is too hard. Well, I've had a mighty big imagination.
So he must be a mighty big God.
So he must be a mighty big God. If you believe that, let me hear you say, yeah. If he stepped out on the banks of nothing, created this whole universe, he scooped up some clay, made man in his image, just by saying a very few words, made the sun shine in the day, the moon at night, in the sky he hung the stars. If he can do all of this and so much more, then he must be a mighty big God. Cause he said that he can do more than I can ask for. And for him, nothing is too hard. Well, I've got a mighty big image. Y'all say,
so he must be a mighty big God.
I believe I got some church folk in here. I don't know right where you are, but it's some up in here anyhow. One more verse. If the cattle upon 1,000 hills he alone owns, and not only the cattle, but even the hills that the cattle choose to walk on. If it's his good pleasure and it makes him happy to give his kingdom to me, then I'm about to do everything that I can to make sure that he is really pleased. Cause he said that he can do more than I can ask for. And for him, nothing is too hard. Well, I've got a mighty big imagination.
So he must be a mighty big God.
He said that he can do more than I can ask for. And for him, nothing is too hard. Well, I've got a mighty big imagination.
So he must be a mighty big God.
If you believe that we serve a mighty big God, I dare you to clap those hands. Let me see if you agree. If he can heal cancer when nobody else can,
he must be a mighty big God.
All of my problems he alone understands.
Then he must be a mighty big God.
If he can reach down and save a wretch like me,
then he must be a mighty big God.
If he can heal all kinds of diseases,
then he must be a mighty big God.
Look, if he can hold the world in the palm of his hand,
then he must be a mighty big God.
The hairs that used to be on my head, if he knows every strand,
then he must be a mighty big God.
If he stepped out on nothing and made him a world,
then he must be a mighty big God.
Didn't stop there. He made men, he made women, little boys and little girls.
Then he must be a mighty big God.
If he can handle all of your problems and still handle mine,
then he must be a mighty big God.
This is important. If he can handle Washington's problems at the very same time,
then he must be a mighty big God.
Look, if he was there in the beginning, and he'll be there in the end. Look at somebody sitting next to you and say, well, I've got a mighty big imagination.
So he must be a mighty big God.
Since I've got a mighty big imagination, then that must mean we serve a what? Oh, yeah. I read the Bible a lot, and I